July 1863. Confederate President Jeff Davis urges Lee to take the battle to the north. Lee sends Jeb Stuart around Union lines to invade the north in Pennsylvania. Stuart stumbles upon Gettysburg for no other reason than it warehouses boots, badly needed by his soldiers. Union generals Buford and Meade both converge on the rural Pennsylvania town. In no time at all, a ferocious battle begins. On the second day of fighting, in spite of the advice of his generals, Lee starts to attack the enemy's flanks at Little Round Top. The Federals must hold this position, or their entire line will be exposed to the southern attack.
Soldier, a sizable line of Rebs is coming down on us fast. Use your sniper rifle to pick them off. It's the only chance we got. No mercy! Victory, man! They're on the run! This is from Uncle Robert! They're ours, man! Keep going, man! Kill them all! No mercy! Victory, man!
Die where you stand!
Yeah!
Keep going, man! They're falling back! This is from Uncle Robin! Victory, man.
Take over the big Gatling gun, son. Mow down anything that isn't already dead.
Victory, man!
Commander Chamberlain, we are running out of ammo. Fix bayonets, men. We're going to charge. We got no other option. Move!
Man! glory! We got him! No mercy!
Fix bayonets, man! We're going to charge!
The third day of battle is no less fateful. Sensing victory, Lee orders General George Pickett to charge an open field, where behind a stone wall, the Union Army holds Cemetery Ridge. At 2 p.m., Pickett begins his charge with 13,000 men. Red flags wave and bayonets shine in the July sun. It's an unimaginable slaughter. Single cannon blasts from the Union side kill a dozen packed together bodies at once. The Confederates reach the stone wall at one place only. They are all captured or killed. Taking full responsibility for the disastrous charge, Lee will never again attempt to invade the North. 6,500 Confederates die or are taken prisoner. All in all, 51,000 men on both sides are killed during 3 days of warfare. Despite Lincoln's urgent pleas, Meade refuses to attack the retreating army. His own troops are too exhausted. No one knows it yet, but it's the beginning of the end for the Confederacy. In late November of 1863, the Western Theater of War is not going well for the Union. After a crushing defeat at Chickamauga Creek, the North withdraws back to Chattanooga. Remarking that General Rosecrans looks stunned and confused like a duck hit on the head, Lincoln replaces him with Ulysses S. Grant. Southerners hold three key positions overlooking the city. General Hooker attacks the South's left flank, Sherman the right. Losing his way in the mist, Sherman charges in the wrong direction. Along with Sheridan, Grant orders the hero of Chickamauga, George Henry Thomas, to assault the center of the rebel stronghold. It's a bold but dangerous decision.
You don't think I ain't? They got nowhere to go! My brother was killed in a bull run, and my mother passed right afterwards. This is all I...
It's straight from family!
Give it all!
Come closer. There's a weak spot. Enemy lines. Take the news to the commander north of here. Tell him to attack and breach their lines. I wish I could be there with you, son.
Commander is dead, but we will not give up. Join us for this final assault. We will send them back to Richmond. Men, prepare to fight!
After capturing Lookout Mountain, General Phil Sheridan of the Union is so emboldened that he attacks the South's next stronghold, Missionary Ridge, without direct orders to do so. No matter. Nothing the Confederates can do is able to stop him. They withdraw after taking enormous losses. It's a great victory for the North, and the glory goes entirely to Grant, solidifying his hold as Lincoln's top commander. The South will not recover from this stunning defeat, which brings about Bragg's dismissal and opens up the path to the Southern heartland.